morning, guys. I'm a little bit hungover. I had a good night last night.
Cheers!
Didn't get home till quite late, but now I'm off to brunch with the girls. So every couple of months, me and a group of friends, we just get brunch somewhere. And today we're trying somewhere out called Nature. So I haven't been there before. I think it's a new place and I'm going on my upgrade. So I now have a semi-automatic. I've upgraded from the scooter and I'm now learning to ride this. It's a little bit tricky because on the scooter you have brakes on both sides. On this one, the brakes are on the right with your foot. So before, my brakes were on both sides on the handles, and now brakes with the foot, and it's got a clutch. So left hand side is the clutch and you press down with your foot, and there's a bar that you press down on, and to go up a gear and to go down a gear you slip your foot underneath the bar and you flick it up, but then you have to let your hand off the accelerator quite slowly, otherwise you sort of jerk forward. So I'm learning. definitely enjoying it. So I'm taking this today. The only problem, of course, is the weather. Is for some reason it has not stopped raining at all. This is supposed to be the short dry season, and it really isn't. So I went out the other day to see a friend and I got completely drenched. I got halfway to the restaurant and I had to turn around and come home again. So I'm still learning about weather as well. But this is really cool. So let's go off to brunch. Thankfully, it's only just down the road, so it's about 5 minutes away. So let's go.
So here we are going over a speed bump. I'm pushing down on the brake with my right foot and popping my left foot under the bar to change down a gear, then letting my foot off as slowly as I can for a smooth transition. This lorry coming past, it just says meat, nothing else. Beeping me why? There's no one else on the road, I'm not blocking you or anything. Why are you beeping me? Years ago, there used to be the creepiest abandoned fairground on the right. My cousin was visiting once and we were coming home from a bar around 1 a.m. with some friends, and the guard agreed to show us round by flashlight. It was so cool. Sadly, it's all gone now. a really lovely leafy lane. It's much nicer than the busy main roads. So coming up on the right is a place called Century Park, and they do a fabulous Chinese brunch on weekends. Definitely worth checking out. Stray dog ahead, littlest hobo. Down the road, that's where I'll always be. Right, so the GPS reckons I should have gone up that road on the left, so I'd better turn around. Here we go. Can we just take a moment here to appreciate the stabilisation on the Insta360? Just look at how much the mirror's wobbling, and the camera doesn't even blink at this. Flow state is so damn impressive. Definitely not convinced by these GPS directions. If in doubt, stop and fiddle with your phone. Can't really tell, but this is a really steep hill. Keep an eye on this car coming up.
Oof. Hey, where the fuck am I going? Huh?
He says follow us, but not this road.
I have to go down to turn around.
I think I might go down.
This road is so bad. It's really, really bad, yeah. This is not fun.
What were the chances of that? Those are my friends that I'm going to brunch with. Their GPS had done exactly the same thing. And off we go. Look at me changing gears like a pro. Top gear now. Century Park. Coming up on the left is Nyarutarama Tennis Club. They have a great swimming pool with a restaurant. It's a pretty good place to hang out poolside with a beer, so long as it's not the school holidays. Another really steep hill. I really feel for this bloke pushing crates up it on a bicycle. So glad my friends know where we're going, because I have got no idea. I think we found it. And the nice thing about having a bike is you can usually find a place to park.
Well, that was entertaining.
So Nature's just opened. It's got a really nice big garden, which is very family friendly. It's also got a really good selection of vegetarian and vegan food.
And this very comfortable sofa.
Now, the food did take an extremely long time to come. We say in Rwanda that you never wait until you're hungry to order food. But they are new, so the wait time will probably come down as the kitchen gets more experienced. However, when the food did arrive, it was absolutely gorgeous. This is the veggie burger and the chicken wrap with roast rosemary potatoes. This is their quiche, and I could happily have eaten a second portion. It was that good. And these are the pancakes, which came with syrup. So, hands down, I highly recommend this place. Nature in Nyarutarama. Link below.